Hey everybody, up for your consideration today, I got two Sanitronic Kirbys to run for you. The Sanitronic 7 was one of the VACs in the recent pickup, specifically the pile of machines that I've finally gotten through that I plan on keeping. The DS80 is one of three now, and was a machine that I got from my guy the last time I got that giant load of vacuums, from him obviously. This thing was all original. The brush roll was trashed. As you see, it even has the original little bag tag. The fan and fan side bearing were completely trashed. That motor was pretty much unsavable just for how jammed together it was. It was not coming apart. Though I know these older machines are definitely known for it being a tedious task to get the fan off, let alone take the motor apart. So it was been sitting here as a wait for a donor motor. But lucky for me, in the dumpster dive the other day, I found a DS80 motor along with several other Kirby motors. I believe there's a G3, a G4, obviously the Sanitronic 7, a rather incomplete Heritage, and then a classic Omega, which I did save. I don't think I'm going to save the Heritage as much as I'd like to, because I don't have a Heritage. It's missing a lot of stuff. But anyway, so that motor checked out good. Actually, I've only had in the pile of vacuums that I wanted to keep one machine that actually wasn't bad, and that was one of the smart vacs. Sadly, it was the red one. I wanted to keep that one, and I had already parted out the blue one, so it was what it was. So yeah, you know, even for having been in a dumpster for a couple days and in storage for how much longer before that, everything so far has worked, including the Kirbys and the spare motors. So swapped that motor in, buffed it up, all that good shit. Works great now. Same with the Sanitronic 7. There was nothing wrong with that. Obviously didn't have a cord. What else? Oh yeah, that's that. And then, because the, this head is off of the original machine because I'd already had it polished and it had less gouges in it than the one that came with the, replacement motor. And luckily it had a good brush roll in it. So that saved me there. So with that, we'll give these a run. And I have a couple other things I'm going to share with you guys, since we're finally running vacuums in the vacuum room. If we're lucky, there'll be a lot more room in here soon, but we'll get to that. Trip on myself. Steal the 80s cord for the Sanitronic 7. We don't gotta get all proper with it, we just gotta plug it in. So there we have the new Sanitronic 7 and the newest DS80 back in action, ready to roll up on the shelf with its other ones. So, orders of business. Just wanted to maybe ask opinions, show everybody what's going to be happening here. Obviously, there are like 20 new vacuums that I want to add. And if you know my basement or you see it now, there ain't no fucking room in here. Something's got to get done because, well, I want to add those machines and it's going to happen. The biggest problem, actually, is the 3 Hoovers I want to add. Maybe just 2. But even then, say 2 Hoovers and 2 Kirbys, and then eventually the Wide Path Royal. The problem is the Kirbys were originally just supposed to stay on the shelf. Well, they all fit on the shelf when I moved in here. So since then I've added, actually I think the G5. I only had the G5 as a G-series when I moved here. But anyway, so just to give you perspective, when I moved here, all the Kirbys except for the G5 fit on the shelf. I now have my Tradition, Heritage 2, 2 G3s, the new Classic Omega there, and the Sanitronic 7. There's also like a very, very incomplete of that thing, whatever that is, which I think right now is a hodgepodge of Kirby's, and it's not even anywhere near complete, as you see. But anyway, so there are officially 1, 2, 3, well, there's officially 3 that need to be added in here somewhere, and I'd like them all off the floor. And that's not going to happen. And then, so we're adding, actually, technically, we're only adding in 2 Kirbys. And we're adding in 2 Hoovers, maybe 3. And as you see, this side of the room is packed. This side of the room is packed. I've already got a couple spaces here that are going to get filled by the Royal Precision and then something else. And then, as you see, over here is pretty damn packed. Might be able to get the 2 canisters that I want to keep. That's about it. So, new plan is I'm going to take all the canisters, their power nozzles, and accompanying hoses, and set them up in my spare bedroom. Same shelf, probably same layout. Only difference will be I'll have the hoses connected to the power nozzles, either like hung on one of the walls or, you know, stacked in rows like vacuums. Because that's been something that's kind of disappointed me. Is I like to use canisters. I'm not like I don't like canisters. Obviously, I own enough of them, but to use, say, to use any canister here, I first have to obviously pick out whatever canister I want. I have to find the accompanying power nozzle, which could be hanging up in the rafters there, hanging up over here, or stacked in the closet there. If it happens to be stacked in the closet there, I got to find the accompanying wand, which is probably stacked in the corner there. In addition to that, all the hoses are in that closet. To get in that closet, I got to take the touch-up and the roommate off the wall. I got to move 3 or 4 of these canisters here to open it up. By that time, I've already given up on vacuuming altogether and say, fuck it, it can wait. Or, you know, I pick an upright that's easier to access and, you know, neglecting to use the canisters. Unless I'm really adamant on taking a rainbow out, which has happened a couple times. So I'd really like to fix that situation of assembling the canisters to use easier, have easier access to them, which I think this is a genius idea to have the power nozzles and wands and hoses already assembled, ready to go. Hopefully they'll all fit in that room neatly and I'm not tripping over myself going in there because that's not going to happen. Now, granted, that does go against like the biggest rule I had after I moved was no vacuums reside upstairs. I built the vacuum room for a reason. They were supposed to stay in here. And, well, gung-ho, it didn't fucking work. I keep getting more vacuums that I want to add, and I just can't help myself. So I guess I'm going to have to use the spare bedroom. But at this point, that room really is doing nothing. In fact, the biggest item in the room is the file cabinets, pretty much full of vacuum parts. So, yeah. I don't know why I'm putting the camera over there. We're going to set up pretty much everything on this side, this end of the room in there. That cabinet there is all my attachments and cords and crap, which I can barely ever get to with all the phantoms in the way. Going to put that up in the bedroom there, put all the canisters and that shelf up there, all their power nozzles, all that crap. So that should allow me to shift either some of this shit into the corner or all of this shit into the corner. I'm thinking I'm going to start by taking everything that's commercial vacuum. Like, you know, the Windsors and the Wide Paths and all that, my Double Duty, et cetera, and start by putting that over here. And then give my Hoovers their room, give the Kirbys their room, and then see what's left over, wherever it's left over, whatever it is. So, that's that, if any of that made any sense. Just thought I'd enlighten everybody on that. I have to paint that bedroom first. I kind of got started on it today. If anybody didn't know, I'm a contractor by trade, and I hate painting with a passion. I would rather snake your dirty toilet than paint. And that was like the procrastinating factor on the remodeling of the rest of the house. And so the last thing on the list was paint that room. And I'm like, that room don't matter. But now that I came up with this genius plan yesterday, that room's got to get painted so I can start packing vacuums in there. So that all said, hope you enjoyed the new Sanitronic 7, the DS80. And at some point, we'll run that classic Omega. And then, as always, I try to keep everybody updated. So, hope you enjoyed.